Hi guys, that's me in here, and this is going to be a quick video, and we're doing quick, just the Fallout 4 contraptions, all the new things. This is not going to be a detailed guide on how to use any of them, how to use the new stuff. I'm just literally going to be showing you what there is, what the new DLC has to offer, and all the fun can be had. So we're going to get it started. What? What are you saying? A lot of people could use, yeah, whatever. So we're going to start off, so we've got marquees are new, arrows, different directional arrows you can build, pretty sure these different ones, here we go, different arrows for all your needs, so you can advertise your motels, your hotels, this way for great food. You have acrylic letters, look at that tiny little bee on the floor there. I don't know what it's used for, but there's a tiny little bee you can have running around your settlement. So moving on, we've got conduits, or conduit, however you say it. These are basically instead of wires, I assume. So you connect it up to a power and then you can run this all the way through your settlement, going from one end to the other. You can put them on walls, you can stick them, here we go, you can stick them on walls, you can stick them a bit everywhere. You get long ones, short ones, thin ones, fat ones, curly ones, ugly ones, ones with red hair, ones with glasses, and you get switch. Obviously you get switch. So that's just alternatives to wires, just in case you don't like wires. The next thing we'll show you is a rolling metal door. I'm pretty sure this is new, I think. If it's not, I do sincerely apologise. The coolest thing we're going to move on to is weapon racks. So here we can see a ball hardened pistol. We have a 10mm, a silver submachine gun. My beautiful baby girl up there. Kiss, kiss. Cheers. So obviously new thing, weapon racks. So you can transfer. Oh, hang on, can't do that. Denied. I haven't got a pistol. I apologise. But there's different racks. So you've got a short rack, long rack, pistol rack. And you can only put one gun, it's one weapon per rack. So you've really got to be careful where you put it. But that is the pistol racks. You can basically put them any wall, any surface. This one's a door. I don't know what would happen if the door opened. Let's do that now, actually. Let's break Fallout. Oh, there we go. First glitch. First glitch. Rename the title. Fallout 4 glitches. So, clearly, not perfect at all. By far from it. So weapon racks can go on any door or wall. Glitch the game out. There we go, that's better. So there we go. Another weapon rack. Skip past all this, is the heavy weapons rack. Show you right there. So a minigun fits in a heavy weapons rack. It's for your heavy weapons, the minigun, laser gatling gun, anything like that. So the next thing I suppose I should show you is the armor racks. They come in male and female. My male armor rack is a hidden. They go right here. You can give them clothes, whatever you want. Give an army helmet. Stick an army helmet on. Very easy. Useful for people who don't have mods. There we go. Very useful for people who don't have mods. So there you go. Stick them on again. Nice, simple. Easy to use. And as I said, male and female, any sizes you want, yeah? There was also another thing to decorate your home, make your settlement homes look beautiful, is display cases. So display cases, they require you to manually add your own stuff. So as I did with this 10mm pistol, you can pick it up, move it, put it in a case, and close it again. And that is more or less how the display case works. There's no actual set activation. You can just style it the way you want. So you get it in there, look it nice and pretty. Close it down. So there you go. Display cases. It works slightly differently to the armor racks and weapon racks. But that is a display case for you. That's how they work. Just like the old good old Skyrim days. So, the next thing similar to them, I suppose I should tell you about, is go upstairs. Pretty sure he'd one up here. No, I was wrong. I lied. So we'll just move on to this. Basically, this is the new warehouse. So you can find it under structures. This is the prefab. So this is the one you get built standard. Pretty small. So I don't think it's going to be what you guys are looking for. And obviously, you get prefabs, walls, roofs, corners, houses, floors, walls, stairs. New types of stairs. Two new types of stairs. They look a bit cooler. They look a bit rustic. New doors, glass doors, rusty doors, holy doors, crappy doors that you don't actually ever want because they look disgusting. New posts, I built, here's some I made earlier. Two posts. Oh, look at them parkour skills. You didn't just, okay, yeah, never mind. Ignore them parkour skills. So that's them. Moving on, I'm sure you've been looking at this guy for a long time.
Let's trade. Sure.
Oh yeah, let's just trade. Yeah, I just traded with someone in the stocks. I'm pretty sure that's called stealing, because I just took everything off him. But oh, sorry. This is the new stocks. I'm pretty sure it's called a pillory. It's called a pillory in the warehouse tab. But I'm pretty sure. Yeah, what do you want?
I just need to trade gear with you.
Of course.
Yeah, give me all your stuff. Oh, he took the flare. He ate my flare. So just a little. I want to see if I can inflict damage on him without the town going hostile towards me. You deserve this.
What just over here?
Oh. Okay, guys, this is Nick. This is bad news because now the entire settlement is against me. I'm probably gonna have to kill everybody before I continue with the video. Oh, this has gone south really fast. This has gone south. Okay, so moving swiftly on, we're gonna go through this quite fast now. Speed up. I'm totally lost because I'm gonna die. I'm gonna get eaten. Hi guys, just ignore me. Oh my goodness.
Put your hands up.
Put your hands up, son. I'll just kill this guy. Okay, but he's totally ruined. Nick! Oh, it's not Nick. Oh, that is Nick. So, come on, guys. Don't play fair. Play nice. Okay, so yeah, so there's them you can build. And, yeah, there's this you can build. And, yeah, you can build all this track and all this. And you can build all this. That's it. Thanks for watching. Goodbye. So there's a little tip for you.
Don't move.
You cannot.
Don't do
anything. Do not kill.
Put your hands up.
The settlers. Yep. If you put any settlers in the stocks, you can't kill them on everyone you know and loved.
Easy now. Hands up.
I just believe I called you guys. Get out of my power armor. Nick, come on. Get out of the power armor, buddy. I didn't want to shoot. I didn't want to shoot you all over there. Yeah, I'm just going to let myself die. Because this is not showing any of the contraptions. Dick Valentine, deactivate yourself right now. What do you think you're doing? Nick, I'm gonna drop the nuke. Keep hitting me on the back of the head. Fight me, Nick. Whoa! I'm pretty sure Nick just fatalited me.
Fatality.
So yeah, do not try to kill a settler or hurt a settler in the stocks, because it still counts as murder and all the settlers still hate your guts. That's a Tatsuman 16 tip. You can take that one home with you. So here we go. There he is. Don't kill this guy. Whatever you do. I'm pretty sure you can punch him once or twice, but that's about it. Don't go so far as to kill him.
Yeah?
Yeah? Shut up. So moving on. Quickly, before they attack me again. Two new sets of scaffolding. Pretty useful as guard towers. So you could set up as guard towers that I did before. I put guards up there. I think this is a pretty good spot to snipe. You can shoot anyone coming. And I should have probably got up here when they were all killing me. Who cares now? So, power armor station, also new. So this one's a bit tricky to use. I'll show you how to use it now. I know I said I wasn't going to show you how to use anything, but just a quick one. So it doesn't work. Oh yeah, basically you have to put the power armor close to the machine. So I'll put it backwards just so you can tell. Close to the machine, and then activate, and it flips it around. And it just gets a little bit of light on the chest. So, kind of cool. Much better than having them all like this.
Since what? We talked, I'm feeling swell.
Cool.
Look at the two.
Yeah, here in Sanctuary, prepared for the future. Sanctuary. Yeah, blah, blah.
Prepared for the future.
Cool. Cool story, bro. So, yeah, it looks better than having them all clumped up in this dark room. Have them out on display with a bit of light on them. So that is a power armor display. So the next thing, I suppose, is a box car. Or a train, if you where I live, just call it a train. Box cars, they come in orange, they come in blue. You can build them a door. So it's cool, nice little den. The doors do come separately, I'll show you quick. If it won't work yet, so the doors come off. You can pull the door off. You can attach the door, pull the door straight off. So it's, there's a separate door. So it doesn't all come as one, so you do have to build it yourself, but I think it's pretty cool just to experiment with and build with boxcars, trying to build a secret base if you can.
You hear about that farm run by ghouls? Isn't that something?
Yeah, isn't it? It's pretty cool. North, stop interrupting. So, oh, two things here, actually. One is a stationary gun, which is new, obviously found under defense. Turrets, defense, and then all the way to the end. Nope, they're on traps. I apologize. On traps, all the way to the end, under traps. And you've got two types of guns, a paintball gun and a gun. Yeah, a gun, one of them. A gun. So they both work, when powered, they start shooting. Instantly shoot when powered. Oh, nice, look at this colour again. Oh, let's see if I can hit this. Oh, we did, we hit it. So, as the paintball gun shoots here, and the normal gun, this is a firing target, so I do believe when you shoot it, or when you hit it, power will be supplied. I'm not too sure how it works. But obviously, you hit it, the power gets supplied to whatever it's attached to. If any brain boxes out there can figure out what it can be used for, that's its use. I'll show you if I can hit it. Nope. So you hit it, and power gets supplied to whatever it's attached to. Let's not do it again. Because my aim sucks. Because I'm a little bitch, that's why. Okay, can't hit it again. Because my character's a little bitch. So yeah, it obviously supplied power to these guns, even though there's already power going to them. So the next thing on the tour of the DLC is this. Big thing in front of me. Yes, I am talking about the track. This is the ball track. A little thing I made earlier. Here's one I made earlier. Doesn't work, by the way. I'll tell you a hint. But to get up there, we'll need to use my elevator. Which I quickly built. Elevators are easy to build. They're in one of the tabs. Yep, they're in one of these tabs. I'll tell you that much. And power? Nope. So they're in structures, elevators, and obviously you can go 2 floor, 3 floor, and I've gone all out, balls to the wall, 4 floor elevator. So pretty simple, you go on there and you can select your floor, floor 3, and it smooths one smoother. I think it's a really cool touch to the game for console users who don't have mods yet, especially if you're on PS4. Really cool touch to the game, takes you up to the 3rd floor, and you can instantly start building. So you just build an elevator and then instantly start building. So this is the ball track that failed, because I realised that the ball track has to be downhill. I didn't do it, because when you put your ball, does it work? Go. So as you see, go in, go in, go in, and it gets stuck. So if you're going to build one of these for yourself, please make sure that the track is flat, it doesn't go uphill, because obviously gravity doesn't work uphill. Don't be an idiot like I was. Don't be an absolute muppet. So don't have bumps in it, yeah, make it flat as possible. So the next thing, which is I think the most interesting thing, is what they call builders. So this is a builder, this is an ammunition builder, and as long as I put materials in, it will constantly poop out ammunition. So put in some rounds, I don't know. And it doesn't seem to be doing anything with these rounds. I'm pretty sure I put junk in. So give me a second, I'm going to gather up a little bit of junk I've got over here. Don't ask why I've got all this pre-war money lying around. Because I'm a lich. So you add junk to builders, and they should make ammunition. I'm pretty certain, I'm going to show you the tab, but I'm pretty certain you do need certain types. Certain types of junk. So, go all the way over here. Manufacturing machinery, and there you go. So you've got a builder. I think that builds junk itself, or certain items. And then obviously, armor forge, weapon forge, auto loom. So it builds clothes, energy weapons forge, heavy weapons forge, ammunition plant, explosives mill. Sounds dangerous. Pyrotechnics mill and a food processor. Food processor sounds pretty cool for those of you wanting to go for the peaceful route. So you attach a terminal to it, like we're going to do now, and I'm pretty sure it's going to tell us what to build. Totally lost on this. Voila, there we go. So we attach a terminal up. Here we go, log in. Ammunition plant control, there we go. So select an item to manufacture. Let's make shotgun shells. Never have enough shotgun shells. Oh, there we go. So you require 2 lead, 2 plastic, and 2 fertilizer. To build a shotgun shell. So as long as you have in it lead, plastic and fertilizer, you'll be good to go. So what I'm going to try and do is get that stuff going in actually. So manufacturing, conveyor, it's just a quick play around. I'm just quickly going to play around with this. Here we go, let's try this now. Log on to your Club Penguin account. I don't have a Club Penguin account. I do, you got me. I do. So there we go. Oh, look at this. Toy truck, rocket ship, toy alien. So let's build a giddy up buttercup. Why not? And it needs 4 gears, 5 springs, 5 screws and 7 steel. So that is a lot actually. So let's go out. I want to build some shotgun shells. So we're going to go and gather up a lot of junk. I'm just going to give a quick demo of how the builders work. Take all this, literally take all this. I'm going to use it to make just a little demonstration. Here we go. Oh, take all. Oh, okay. That would have been much easier. That would have been much easier. So you need the required amount of junk. Put them in your builder, access the terminal, and then you can build the item. So the builder's not as good as we thought, guys. It doesn't give me what I thought I was going to get anyway. So, transfer. My junk. Start putting this in there. Oh, look at that, guys. 2,000 carry capacity just for all my junk. Seesaw, that's actually, let's find lead, so we need some lead. Lead, oh we got 9 lead actually. Lead. Just put a bit of junk in there. There we go. Use terminal. Got ammunition plant control. There we go, it should start making. Oh, there we go, look at that. Whoa, look at that, guys. And it just pumps out one. It should give me one 10mm round. That's pretty cool. Oh, two, there we go, there's two. Oh, look at that, and then they just pile up at the end. There's two 10mm rounds. Let's play around the builder. Oh, not that. What am I doing? You can see this, it's dependent on junk, so I will suggest you have a lot of spare junk lying around before you go into this DLC. But it's a cool way of getting your own ammo instead of buying it from vendors, because that gets a bit boring, doesn't it? It's a bit more fun to produce that kind of stuff. Just gonna put all this in there. Let's see if we can make anything. So it's builder control. Steel ball. 5 steel. We're gonna start making that. Here we go. Steel. Where's my steel? Where's my steel, guys? 902 steel. So there we go. Oh, I actually think it's doing it. Oh yeah, and we're just making steel balls. There we go. We're gonna have an infinite supply of steel balls. And let's check our 10mm ammo. Look at that, stacking up nicely. Lots of 10mm rounds. Very nice. Oh yeah, look at this, steel balls. So that is the builders working nicely. The conveyor belts and the builders working very nice. I think the last thing to show you, one of the last things to show you would be the firework mortar, which does as it says on the tin. So you put a firework mortar down. You need to build it at your chemistry station or a pyrotechnics mill. a pyrotechnics builder, like I've just showed you. So let's jog our fat ass up here, if I can catch some breath. Yeah, come on, you're lazy. So, chemistry station, and they should be on here. Fireworks, there you go. So emergency flare shell, crackle, palm gold. Let's have a nice. Oh, look at this, weather change shell. So you can change the weather. Let's get a bit of rain, shall we? And then firework shell, let's put a bit of red in there. I want to also try out the emergency flare. So let's go stick these flares. Pretty sure they automatically fire. Here we go, we'll see anyway. Come on, drag your fat little ass over. Oh, we have loads of steel balls now. Steel balls for days. So would there be an aid? Nope. Ammo, possibly. No, so they must be in junk. They must be in junk then. That's the only place they could be. I assume. Mods, ammo. Oh, I've lost them, guys. I have lost them. But they're not in ammo. Where I thought they'd be. Weapons. It's not a weapon, is it? Firework? Yeah, no, a firework can't do anyone any harm. Of course it can't. Oh, there we go. They're in MISC. So if you're looking for them, they're in MISC. So let's go put the firework shells in there. So there's three firework shells in there. Let's hook it up to that. Hey! Whoa! That shakes the screen far more than I realised. Earthquake! Earthquake! So they are super fast, guys. Where's the other one gone? They went really fast, actually. Emergency flare shell. Help! Oh, this will look cool. Very nice. And I'm assuming that calls the Minutemen. I'm going to guess that signals the Minutemen to come and help out. Which is faster than equipping your flare gun if you haven't got it quick saved. And the last one. Weather change shall rain, so I'm hoping it starts to rain once this gets shot up. Ooh. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Isn't that weird how you have the power to control the skies and the heavens? So that was the final major thing to show you guys, the firework mods. Oh no, actually, what about this big thing? Nick, can I go on the computer, please?
Hey, thank you. When you were in Dima's memories, did you find anything? Any proof about what really happened between us?
Oh, Nick, we haven't got time for this. We're in the middle of a video.
Haven't found anything yet, Nick.
Really?
Yes.
Too bad.
Yeah, it's too bad.
Let me know if that changes.
Yeah, okay. We're in the middle of a video, yeah? So do you want to delete your search history before I go on this computer? No chance. So a junk mod control. Recommended. Let's go to the recommended, shall we? And apparently this is supposed to fire when junk is inside. I was playing around with it earlier and it didn't seem to work. There you go. Junk more. Junk's in there. It should fire. I assume. It should just shoot this. I'm gonna give it a second. I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna be a patient man. And I'm gonna have a wait. No, I'm pretty sure it would have done it already, guys.
Anything I can lug for you?
No, I'm okay, Nick. This is the last thing. I promise you this is the last thing. And I've been saying that forever now. Picture machine. Put your junk in here. And this one does, as it said, this one does actually just shoot your junk. There we go. Just shoots everything else. So there you go. That is everything you can build in the contraptions DLC. Some of the cooler things. So you've got, showed you earlier. You got the armor racks, the weapon racks. You've got the sizes for different guns. You've got pistols, mini guns, long guns, and then you've got the weapon. So you can customize it everywhere, and then you've got the armor. So you've got male and female body types. Put any armor on there, more or less exactly the same as you would in any other game, any other Bethesda game, something like that. And then you've got the structures, so you've got the new warehouse. The new warehouse things you can build. You've got prefab. Going along, you've got... hey look, and there's a Minuteman. That we carved with our flare. So that's pretty cool. So it does work.
Minutemen are always ready to help.
The flare would just fire Dick Minuteman. So yeah, anyway, you've got the structures, the scaffolding. So there you go, you've got a boxcar, a hitting machine, yeah, the hit machine that I have no idea what it does, chemistry station, you've got your power armor show off, which I think is really cool, especially if you have something nice to watch, like a Vim, like a beautiful Vim, the pillory.
Yeah.
Yeah, were you talking to me? Don't kill him. You've seen that. Don't kill him. You've got... Go away, buddy. So there you go, your display cases work like old-time Skyrim. You manually have to put stuff in there, and it's on display. Works differently. You've got your lights, your new lights, your new arrows. Something to try. What I am going to try now, guys, is I'm going to put a vacuum hopper on a workbench. Because I just had a funny feeling. So I'm just going to put a vacuum hopper on a workbench. Because my inner shout out to Christopher Thompson. Christopher Thompson.
Our little sanctuary revival project has really helped.
So I'm pretty sure I've seen it before. In case you're wondering when this is out, it's out midnight local time. So I'm in the UK, so for me, midnight was 2 hours and 4 minutes ago. So this has been released for 2 hours and 4 minutes, actually. It gets released across EU and America, your local time, so... A hopper? Vacuum hopper on a workbench. A vacuum hopper on a workbench. On the red workbench? On this? No? I'm pretty sure this isn't what you meant, is it? But what I'm going to do is stick it here. They'll get rid of this firework machine. Vacuum hopper. So apparently this is like a vacuum cleaner. Oh, it didn't do it. So the description says, the description of this says it pulls items out of an adjacent container from wherever it is. So the last thing we're going to do on this video is try to get this to work. It doesn't snap onto anything. Yeah, it's not going to snap on when I keep messing up, is it? Right, so we're going to put it over here. Next to the workbench. Oh my goodness. Right, third time's a charm. Cannot mess up this time. I cannot be stupid enough to mess up this time, actually. Adjacent container. Okay, so we're gonna plop it down here, here, here. No, we're gonna plop it down here. We're gonna make some space. So there we go. I just ruined all the weapon racks. I apologize. So they go, move these out of the way. So this is a do not try at home. This is a please get your parents' permission before calling in.
Don't let all that horsepower go to your head.
Okay, cheers, Nick. I don't recommend putting a vacuum hopper next to your workbench.
I know I'm not the only person.
I have a feeling this is going to go terribly wrong. This is going to be a nice bit of disaster for the end of the video.
The others? They told me to stop worrying. They said you can't be killed. But you'd always come back.
Tell you something, Sean, they were lying to you. You can always be killed. I could kill you right now. I could. It'd be child abuse, but I could. Sean, come on. Come on. I thought we were a weird father and son relationship. Nick! Move, please.
Find anything in Dima's memories?
Oh, you asked me this like 2 seconds ago. Okay, let's try if this is close enough. Let's see if this is close enough now. No? Is the mayhem working? I have a feeling this is going to go terribly wrong. But there's always a bit of fun, isn't there? I'm going to get this to work. I am not that incompetent. Here we go. Here we go, and voila, fit, like right now, like fit, like, come on, like fit. Oh. Come on, how close do you need to be? how close do you need to be? Right, guys, just bear with me while I get these lovers together. Apparently need to be right up in the face of each other. Shift armor suits a power armor. So again, this is a hopper. This is a hopper. Oh, hang on, we got it pretty close then. Oh, what's this? Oh! Boomstick McShootington! How did you get here? How did my shotgun get there? That's pretty cool. Oh my goodness, is this just pulling everything out? Oh, this better not be just pulling everything out of my workshop. Oh my goodness, I think it is. Oh, I think this is pulling everything out of my workshop. Okay, guys, yeah, as I suggested, this is magically pulling everything out of my workshop and just dumping it on the floor. This is the... this is not a bad idea, actually. Pretty sure this is how you get... this is how you start everything. I'm pretty sure this is how you start a big chain of command. So, a vacuum hopper is what you need to start it. Hook it up to your workshop and then just get it covered. Get more lengths of conveyor belts. And then you can hook it up to different machines. And I'm pretty sure you could start making your own ammunition. Just like this. No hassle, no fuss. Next up is a piece of wood. And a piece of wood. Yeah, what I guess. Another piece of wood. Yeah, what I guess. And another piece of wood. And another piece of... Oh, look at this. And I'm going to guess a piece of wood next. Brilliant. And next I'm going to guess a... Oh, look at this. Mass production. You didn't see that trophy, but I just got a trophy called mass production. Another piece of wood. So, actually, we're going to give it a bit of a try. I said we weren't going to do anything. But we've got to do something now we've figured it out, haven't we? Now we've figured out how to do it. We've got to have a little play with it. So, manufacturing conveyor belts. Let's just get your standard issue conveyor belt. Okay, can we turn this off, please? Please turn this off. Please. Please, for the love of all that is holy. Please. Thank you. I'm not going to stand here doing this. I'm going to do it the smart way.
Building a collection or something?
Yes, I am, Nick. Please mind your own business. Oh, that's pretty cool how everything gets stopped halfway. So we're going to try and mass produce something. Cool, guys. So, bog standard conveyor belt. Does it connect? Hello? So that's a sorter. So you're gonna need one of these. So you get the hopper. So I'm gonna connect it to a conveyor belt. If it will work. There we go. I'm not sure they're connected actually. I'm not convinced they're connected. I'm pretty sure it should just snap too, like everything. Oh, it's the wrong way around, that's why. Oh no, this is gonna be just... Okay, let's deconnect this before this just gets out of hand. That was almost a disaster. So let's flip it around. There we go. Flip it around again. I don't know why it's doing that, actually. Flip it around again. Get rid of the water, because nobody needs water to drink. Who actually needs water in their life? So the end goal here is going to be to mass produce something. We're going to mass produce ammunition is the main goal. I'm pretty sure that won't work. Yes, no? Give us a yes. So all this stuff's going to come down here. It needs to get sorted. So sorter. Yeah, sort it out. So that one. Where's the snap to? If you're wondering how to build, guys, it should always snap to. So if you've played Fallout, you know what I mean by that. So when you get close, it just snaps to the conveyor belt, and it doesn't seem to be doing that. Maybe because the cow's in the way. Which side does it snap to? That side. No? No? Not having it? Not playing, are we? Pretty sure it should come in like that. Should. I say should. Let's power this up and see what it does. That is the longest wire I have ever seen. The stuff goes in there. Okay, stuff goes in this way. Yes, logic. Logic, my friends. We've figured it out. Okay, so I don't know why, but it needed to be attached to a tiny conveyor belt. Buddy, come on. Come on, buddy. Don't be like this. So yeah, it needs to be attached to a conveyor belt. I don't know why. I don't know why it decided to be that fussy. Terminal. So you attach a terminal. There we go. And this will allow you to control... power, obviously. This is going to allow you to control what gets sorted.
I'll try to make myself useful.
Yeah, you can help me out if you want. Hopper control. Please choose output time, output force. I don't really want any of these. 2 seconds. It's fast enough. And force. I don't really want force that great. Like a one. I don't want anything to be forced out.
Grown man feeling sorry for himself.
Huh. Sorta. I have a feeling that terminal was connected to something else. Because I don't think this is a hopper. Alright, we're going to carry on with the conveyor belt. If it will let us. It's not clear, actually, guys. Is it? Hang on, that snapped too. Yes, there we go. And now we might as well just attach it to a machinery. So, builder, armor force, weapon force. Slap it to weapon force. Bit too high. There we go. Is that going to be a bit too low? I can see it being a bit too low. And then weapon force. And then we get this terminal. And we hook it up to the weapon thing. So weapon forge, hopper control, weapon forge control. Let's make a pipe gun. I don't think you need a lot to make a pipe gun. What do you reckon? Yes, you do need loads. Let's make a 10mm. So you need loads for 10mm. Let's make a flamer. Let's not. Let's make a double barrel shotgun, because that is my favourite weapon in the game by far. Okay, that's okay. So once this has been made, once this makes things, make sure it conveys out to the side. Conveys back out. I'm pretty sure there you go, convey storage. You can store everything at the end. So let's see if we can connect all this up, shall we? Get a bit of power. Are we running cooking with gas? Yes, we are. So let's follow the first bit of wood. So it sucks things straight out of the workshop. Takes it into the sorter. I hope it doesn't come out this side. No, it doesn't come out this side. Because it just goes straight down. Straight into the weapon forge. And yeah, it just stores itself in the weapon forge until the weapon forge gets what it needs to be able to make a double barrel shotgun. I wondered if we connect a terminal, if we get ourselves a terminal connected to this, can we control the output speed of this? Because that would be massively helpful. No, just weapon and hopper control, which doesn't help me at all. So this is, it's a steady stream. So there we go. So stuff's coming out at two seconds now. Constant stream of stuff out my workbench, which is pretty cool. And it gets stockpiled here. 22 wood in here. Until it knows what it needs. And currently I think I've got it set to make double barrel shotguns at the moment. So the problem I've got with this now is this sorter is not working at all. I don't know why. We're going to figure it out now. Sorts incoming objects when powered based on its current inventory. Okay, so we're going to stop production altogether.
Ain't looking for trouble, I hope.
There we go. And I like it's pretty cool, everything just... Oh, this bit hasn't stopped. Oh, we're going to get backlog. Oh, stop. Well, this has stopped. Okay, it's kind of stopped. Not really, but you know. So get rid of this. Don't want this. So we're going to use the other sorter, this one. And this sorta should work. Should work. Component sorter. Okay. So we've got a component like asbestos. So a component, I'm pretty sure, yeah, so put an extinguisher in there and it should get everything that belongs to an extinguisher, I do believe. You cannot store that here. So let's try this now. I don't know why it wouldn't let me put an extinguisher in there. Let's try this. Hey, dinged. Oh, dear me. Oh, that's not too bad. I've got my wood going this way. And then anything useful will go this way. So I'm pretty sure it works. So it goes up from the alphabet, unless that's the way I've set it, without knowing. Wood in there.
Biggest town I ever saw.
So anything that's wood will now come out this way. And with wood in it gets piled here. Anything like wonder glue carries on. Gets stuck over here.
Yes?
I want talking to you. It's pretty cool. What we're going to do now is build a place for the wood to go. There you go. Gather all this up. So I'm going to put a place for the wood to go. I'm going to see if there's anything that requires wood.
Got a dangerous look about it.
Me? I haven't got a dangerous look about me. Come on, get off. Oh, that's why I'm too fat and I can't run. Because I'm Beth. Anyway, this is what we made earlier. At 10mm rounds. Which is pretty cool. And, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Steel balls for days. We have so many steel balls. Okay, I don't think we need any more steel balls. At all, ever. We have far too many steel balls. I think this was a waste of my steel resources. Yep, definitely a waste of my steel. What I'm gonna do is take all this out. And then we're gonna go build something for the wood to go. And we are gonna build something cool. But anyway guys, as far as the YouTube video goes, this is the end of the YouTube video. I will be streaming again instantly. Just simply carrying straight on with this stream instantly. Won't do it on the YouTube video though. But as far as the video goes, this is the end. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. It was supposed to be a quick run through of everything that you can find, but I kind of ended up messing around with the all the new gazmos and building far too many steel balls. So if you want to see what becomes of my latest contraption I'm building, find me on another stream that I'm going to start up instantly. And apart from that, if you want to...
The Commonwealth can take a real toll on you if you let it.
Nick, you're going to take a real toll on me. Nick, I'm trying to do my outro here and you kind of interrupted me. Yes, as I was saying before I was really interrupted, if you want to stick around for everything Fallout, I will be covering the next two DLCs That is one in July, one in August. Nuka World and Vault Tech. I will be covering them on my channel. So it's Tapsman. Subscribe. I've got other things going on. I recently did an update video. Apart from that, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And if you want to continue watching what I'm doing now, you can find my next stream instantly after this. As always, thank you very much. And I hope you all have a nice day.